Maybe I have a weird mind. I know I have a weird mind, but that does not really matter. Me likey likey the colors a lot. I don't know what I'm going to say next. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki, I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today is another Let's Talk Makeup new makeup releases, where I give my opinion on new makeup releases, sneak peeks and stuff like that. This series is based on Samantha March's Will I Buy It series. Her playlist will be down in my description box, as will the community playlist that she was kind enough to create for people such as me who do these types of videos. So yeah, if you like these types of videos, you can check the playlist and binge watch the playlist. That's, yeah. I do these types of videos because I like to talk about makeup, and in my direct circle, I'm actually the only one. So yeah, I talk to you guys. I'm by no means wanting you to go out and buy everything that I talk about. It is also not to celebrate consumerism or anything like that. It's not. It's also not an anti-haul. I just want to give you kind of beauty news and give you my opinion on it. I don't even know why I say this. Yeah, I do know. But that's neither here nor there. That was what I was looking for. Anyway, let's just get into the rest of the video. The look I have on my face, I filmed. You will see it in, I think, 3 videos. You will see it today. Then you see the video where I do this, which is going to be called something along the lines of sweet and tasty avocado chocolate popcorn. Something like that. So just, yeah, stay tuned on my channel for that. And then also the foundation that I have on my face, I filmed my first impression on.
It's the Max Factor Facefinity All Day Flawless Flexi Hold 3-in-1 Foundation.
It's new? Yes? I have it on my face today. So yeah, I thought let's film a first impression. But there you see at the end of the video this makeup look as well. And also in the thumbnail probably. So yeah. Why? Because today, at this time in space and such, I have time to film all those videos. And I don't know what tomorrow brings. So yeah, that is why you see this look a few times over. I'm going to go to this side today. So yeah, I have Instagram here. I have a bunch. I usually kind of group it. I start with drugstore and then go into indie. I did not feel like it today. So yeah, I hope I have all the brands listed or grouped together. Basically, everything that I will talk about is listed in my description box as well. So yeah, let's start with kind of an update from Asgard Queen Cosmetics. A few weeks back, I talked about the fact that she wants to do mystery boxes. And well, basically my opinion on it. Yeah, that's what these types of videos are for. I actually thought it was a good idea. So yeah, she apparently had more reactions like that, because she's launching the mystery box. Let's see, mystery box is officially launched now. If you are interested in purchase, please read inscription. No, instructions, that was it. So, what do you need to do? You need to choose your style. She has 3 styles. She has glam, nude and creative. Then you can choose the size. You can choose a mini. That is 2 basic products. 1 exclusive product which can be found in mystery boxes only. And a small bonus item. That retails for $15 plus $5.50 for international shipping. She is based in Russia, so yeah. And then the second option you can choose is standard. It's 2 basic products, 2 exclusive products which can be found only in the mystery boxes, and a small bonus that retails for €19. The shipping stays the same at $19 or $5.50 for international shipping. So the shipping is the same. How do you place an order? You send her a DM with the chosen option. Your PayPal account for the money request, the shipping address, receiver's name and a postal code. If you don't have PayPal, she also accepts credit cards. So basically, if you want this, send her a DM and, you know, chat with her about it. She's really, really sweet. And I think, I think I maybe order a mystery box. Then the creative kind. You never know. I'm really interested in this one. So yeah, let's go to the next one, which is from Midas Cosmetics. This is the Wicked palette and it's available now for $20. It is actually pretty unique because you have your orange shades, which is kind of not unique this time of year, but they have paired it with grays. And I haven't seen that combination yet, or at least not vibrant orange like this. I have the coral palette from Juvia's Place, which has grays, but also more kind of muted brownie oranges. I don't know if that darker shade is a matte or a shimmer. It looks to be a satin, which is kind of a shame, actually, because I would have loved to see that as a matte. It's called Rotten, I think. Yeah, the shade names are cute, but not really the colors that I personally see in my head when I hear the names. But that is me. Maybe I have a weird mind. I know I have a weird mind, but that does not really matter. I do like this one, though. I think it's cute. So, yeah, what I understand, Midas Cosmetics formula is really, really nice. So, yeah. Go check it out if you like this color story. Oh yeah, the next is actually something that one of you asked me about. It's from VE Cosmetics. Last week I talked about their I Put a Spell on You palette. I did not have a very, very clear picture. Here I do. Here you see the swatches of the I Put a Spell on You palette. But one of you said that it kind of reminded you of the palette that I will put the swatches underneath. And that is the Blueberry Cosmos Swirl. I had kind of a hard time explaining the difference. I just had a hard time because pictures for me are more clear, you know. So here you see the difference between them. And the difference is actually pretty big in my eyes at least. So yeah, if you thought that they were similar, they're not. Just so you know. So yeah, I really like that I Put a Spell on You palette though, that red. Oh, so pretty. So yeah, again, I did not forget, so yay me. But here you see the difference between both palettes. And yeah, let me know down below what you think. The Blueberry Swirl is already on their channel. And this one, was this one already live? No, release 31st of October on Halloween. So yeah. That's it, basically. So let's go to the next one then. Which is... what's this? Yeah, from who? Oh yeah, Make Up a Murder. Make Up a Murder is... I love the brand, but they have a lot of loose neon-y pigments. They are actually launching pastel pigments. They... let me see. Tomorrow morning. That was 20 hours ago. I'm pre-filming. So it's already live. What does it say here? Do not miss out on our new launch of the Pastel Poison Neon Pigments. Original price $25 for the entire collection or $5 per Pastel Poison Neon only at makeupamurder.com. Due to this product being brand new, it will not be on sale, but you could use an affiliate code for 10% off. There are affiliate codes out there. I think these are really cute. And I like them as a brand so much. I still really want to try their stuff. But yeah, I just haven't gotten around to it. So yeah, if you like Make Up a Murder, they have pastels now as well. And if you have tried them, let me know how they are. I think they're really pretty. Oh yeah, this one from Notoriously Morbid. They are introducing Notoriously Morbid's Halloween 2019 release. Items go live at 1 p.m. EST, so they are already live. I love this name. Hello there, Mr. Fancy Pants. It is brilliant and I think the color is really, really pretty as well. So you see the collage of all the pictures. Those names are fantastic. So you get Drop Dead Moron. Yeah, Drop Dead Moron. It's an icy blue, semi-loose eyeshadow that shifts mint green to Ceruline. What? I'll put it on the screen. I don't know how to pronounce it. I also don't know what kind of color that is. I have no idea. Anyway, the mini retails for $3.25 and the full size for $6.50. Then you get the Hello There Mr. Fancy Pants, an antique gold loose shadow with a strong green undertone, golden sheen and rainbow shifting sparkles. The mini is $3, full size $6. Then you get Yeah, Truly Amazing. It's a plum-colored alchemy matte changeling. What? Plum-colored alchemy matte changeling. Packed full of multicolored sparkles for $15. Then you get Candy Carnage, an orange, gold and white highlighter adorned with blood red drips for $15. Then you get Here's Johnny, a bronzed champagne highlighter with a hefty dose of bright red blood spatter for $15. Count Orlok, a blinding white based highlighter marbled with hints of metallic silver and sparkly black, also $15. Double Tap, a mint green based highlighter that shifts purple to silver to green, $15. Tomb Sweet Tomb Buff Balm. Your tombstone will arrive to you in one of three patterns, featuring a warm purple color with gold motifs. Scent is apple, bourbon, maple and orchid for $9. Then you also get some balms. Absinthe Minded, lime and licorice. Black Widow is raspberry almond. Bloody Mary is apple sangria. Marshmallow Moonrise, chocolate hazelnut and marshmallow. Rum and Raven, Oatmeal Raisin Cookie, and they retail for $3 each. They are, oh my lord, they all look so, so pretty, guys. Wow. I have never tried anything from Notoriously Morbid. Let me know if you have, but this collection looks gorgeous. Just saying. Okay, let's go to the next one, which is Moon Cosmetics. This is a picture of their fall collection. It is close to selling out, so I don't know if it is still available. But it is, let's see, $32, including shipping, if I'm not mistaken, but only in the US. You can DM them to order this bundle. It's very pretty. Yeah. So yeah, this is a color story that really screams my name this time of year, hence the fact that I have a few of these color stories. But yeah, it looks really, really pretty. They are a fairly new indie brand, so go check them out. I will leave their information down below. Let's go to L'Oreal next for new eyeliners. Chroma Morphos Neon Eyeliner. Wow. Neon Eyeliners in Electric Zoo and Neon Green. If they are anything like the Infallible Gel Crayons, the formula will be amazing. And I really like the colors as well. So if they come in store, it could very well be that I will pick them up. Because me likey the colors a lot and the formula is very, very good. Okay, let's go to the next one. I don't know anymore though. I don't know when they will come. I don't know what they will retail for. Probably around 10 euros, I think. Something along those lines. So let's go to Copacetti Cosmetics next, because they have released or are releasing a new palette, which is called the Victorian palette. It is inspired by some of the Victorian era's finest. Let's see, it's a palette of pressed iridescent flakies. I don't know what that means. Not quite pigment, mica, nor glitter. It's a very unique texture of shifting flakies that can be used as an eyeshadow, highlighter and more. You have a blue, that's called Queen Victoria, a purple called Millicent Fawcett, and then a gold, Marie Curie, green called Elizabeth Browning. You see the outer packaging, they look like duochromy whatever shades, with a blue, a darker base. They look very, very pretty. To be quite honest with you, the outside looks really cute as well. Yeah, they're like duochromy, I don't know what they are. But I don't have a price, so yeah, and I don't want to go to the website to find out. Yes, very, very pretty. But please, please include the price in your Instagram post. It would make me so happy. Let's see, because I think I have something else from them. Is it this? Yes. So the next one that I will talk about from Copacetti Cosmetics is the Spooky Ookie palette. I love that. You have a few mattes, you have a few shimmers. You have some duochromy shades. Let's see what they say. Oh yeah, this was what I loved about this. This palette is designed and named by I'm sorry, I don't know if you are a him or a her or in between. I don't know. So I'm just going to say your. But your 6-year-old son. And he's extremely proud of this palette and is so happy at all the sales so far. Thank you for making him feel like a rock star. This is from the Instagram post. He keeps telling me I need to make him my boss. This palette will retire at the end of the month, which is only a few days away at October the 31st. So if you're still waiting to grab one, this is the time. And I thought this was so cute. You know, it is amazing. And I think he did an amazing job with all the shades. I think it is so cute. I really, really love that. Now, the different pen sizes isn't my particular cup of tea. However, you could use them as a face highlight as well, because those are the duochrome shades. I think the palette is really, really cute. So, yeah. I don't know if it is still valid, but it says here that the code RENZO will give you 30% off. I don't know if that is still the case when you are watching this video, but I did want to mention it anyway. I think it is so, so cute. And actually, what I hope is that when you are watching this video and you want to buy the palette, that it is sold out. I know that sounds really, really mean, but still, I hope it sells out, because I think this is so, so freaking cute. And I think the palette is really nice as well. So he really did a good job. Okay, let's go to this from Maybelline, which is a new Dream foundation. This is the radiant version. So it says here, the Dream Radiant Liquid by Maybelline, medium
radiant coverage, lightweight foundation formulated with hyaluronic acid and collagen, moisturizes skin and gives a natural look, delivering up to 12 hours of hydration in 20 different shades, provides a smooth, even looking radiant skin for $11 each.
Radiant foundation is not really something that I gravitate towards, because I feel like they are glittery quickly, and I want to kind of be glittery where I want it to be. Does that make any sense? So I don't know if I will like this though. Maybe I will get a sample. We can get samples here on the drugstore. Maybe I will get a sample to try it out. You never know, but yeah. So let's go to this one then from BH Cosmetics, which is their new mini Zodiac Scorpio palette. So I have seen mixed feedback on this palette. Some say it's boring as hell. Others say, ooh, I like it. I think for me personally, it's kind of lacking. I'm sorry. I do really like the thought behind this, but I think they really dropped the ball, and it's a shame. I wish that red would have been a very, very fiery red, you know? But yeah, so yeah, it's half brown, half gray with a red. That's basically what this is. I actually hope that the darkest shade is a black. Then it would be a bit better. Then it would actually be kind of interesting. But yeah, and can you tell that I'm gravitating towards gray shades at the moment? Anyway, if you think this is boring as hell and you want something a little bit more exciting, maybe you could also go to the Zodiac Cosmetics, because this is their version of the Scorpio palette. I'm still missing a red though, but it is a little bit more colorful. So maybe you like this. They have all 12 palettes. But yeah, I don't know if it is still valid, but it says here, order now at 50% off of the original price. So I will leave the site down in my description box where you can purchase this palette if you want to, and check out all the other palettes. Some of them are really, really cute. So cutesy. So can I just say that I personally, I'm not a Scorpio, but I wish that blue was a red. That's what I wish. If you are Scorpio or just looking at this palette, let me know down below what you think of it. I think that was it. Okay, let's go to the next one, which is a new brand. It is called Brown Melanin Makeup, I believe. And they created a makeup line. This will be their first product. It's the Melanin Fantasy Eyeshadow Palette. It will go on sale when the brand launches at November the 10th. I don't know what is in the launch. I see the eyeshadow palette. So let's talk about that. It is a really nice for this time of year, or at least where we live, going into fall and going into winter. But yeah, you know, I can see this in summer as well. It's pretty. Again, they are just launching the 10th of November. So we don't know how the quality is. I don't know the price. I know nothing. But I did want to mention it to you anyway. Okay, so here you see a picture of a quad from Kraken Cosmetics. It says here, I'm reading off Instagram. It says here, mini introduction of chibi palettes. They are a remix of colors from our other palettes and an easy way to get the pigments you need for looks or swatches on social media, or a great way to try out their formula if you haven't already. We'll update the colors periodically too. This time the colors are Going Clockwise, Arcana, Daisuki Yo, Atomic Bomb and Paladin. I think that's actually a good idea. So you basically get quads where you can kind of try out their formula if you want to, and they change the colors periodically. So yeah, I think this is really fun. Let me know down below what you think of it. Okay, let's go to the next one, which is from Beauty Bay. So they are preparing to launch, let's see, their first ever holiday collection with their Disco Trip set. A set of 4 limited edition eyeshadow pigments and 4 lipsticks. It says here,
take a disco trip and embrace the bold and soft vibes with Beauty Bay's limited edition set of multi-dimensional color play pigments and color rush lipsticks. Featuring 4 multi-use pigments with an ultra-fine and lightweight formula and a mix of 4 matte, sheen and metallic lipsticks with a creamy base formula and lasting power. Made to mix and match, the Disco Trip pigments and lipsticks allow you to switch up your vibe, take it up a level and explore styles you've never tried before. Perfect for partying, date nights, happy hour and everything in between. Set includes, let's see, Baby Color Play pigment, a pink base with purple, gold and blue reflects. Moonlight Color Play pigment, a sea green with gold, silver and purple reflects. Underground Color Play pigment, an electric blue with blue, green and slight gold reflex. Glitch Color Play pigment. Why do they call it these? I think they're doing it on purpose, guys, to make us really, you know, a purple with green gold. Glitch Color Play pigment, yes, a purple with green gold reflex. Dreamy Color Rush lipstick, mid-toned pink green. Electro Color Rush lipstick, a nude bronze metallic. Lust Color Rush lipstick, a plum purple with high gloss sheen. And then Rebel Color Rush lipstick, a raspberry red matte. The set is, if I see it correctly, £35 and will launch soon at Beauty Bay. So let me kind of
take a sip of water and look. Yeah, it looks pretty. I don't know when it will release though. If I know by the time this video goes live, I will include it in the description box probably, or it is flashing on the screen. It's pretty. Let me know what you think of it. What's this? How am I going to pronounce this? Let's see. Ah, this is from wow. This is from Larie Chanté Cosmetics. They are based in the US. Just so you know. This is a picture of their Funhouse palette, I believe it is called. I think so. Why do you not include information? It would be so nice if you would include some more information in your Instagram post instead of who's a color lover. Anyway, this is a very pretty palette. That's the reason that I mentioned it. It looks really, really pretty. It looks fun. I don't know what it retails for and it annoys the hell out of me. And this is a reason for me to not include something in these types of videos. Because I want to give you information. It doesn't say so here. Oh, now I have to scroll through all the products again to get the price of the freaking eyeshadow palette. Ah, here I have it. So the Funhouse palette retails for $26. That's basically it. That's what I wanted to mention. They also have lippies. They have lashes. So yeah, I do think it's a really cute palette. I just wish they would have included a little bit more information in their Instagram post. But yeah, that is me. And I'm allowed to whine about it. Because yeah, that's it. Okay, very, very pretty. I don't know the quality. If you have tried anything from them, let me know down below. So yeah, let's go to the next one. Which is... this is I think this is even an older palette. I just had never seen it before. This is a picture of what's it called again? The Berry. Is it Berry Scary or just Berry palette? Oh wait, it's called the Luscious Plum palette and it's from Pinky Rose Cosmetics. This post is from Instagram from Gleaming Dream. I had never seen this palette before. And apparently it's on sale now on the website, or at least as I'm filming this. I'm filming this on Saturday the 26th. This goes live the 28th on Monday, yeah. So as I'm filming it, it's on sale for €10, $10. I think it's really pretty. I don't think I've heard anyone talk about this palette, have you? But yeah, that is why I wanted to mention it, because I thought it was really, really pretty. And yeah, you know, sometimes older palettes need to get a little bit of love as well. So yeah, let's go to the next thing, which is from Tammy Tanuka. But I know she is also known as something else. Sigil. Yeah, Sigil Cosmetics. Let's see the translation, because the post is in Russian. This, she is based in Russia. She does loose pigments and her multi-chromes are gorgeous. I wanted to show this one. This is so, so pretty. This is one of the brightest shades of the new collection called Invasion. The series of, I don't know, fire, I think, is like lava. The color is flame. It's a Bordeaux. From cold, this is Google Translate, so if I don't make sense, it's probably because of that. From cold burgundy to thick gold, for lovers of chronic, monochromatic shades, whatever. Chronologic, I cannot talk anymore. But this is so freaking pretty. It reminds me indeed of lava. This is such a pretty shade. I want to bathe in this shade, guys. Unfortunately, it is not handy for me to order just one pigment, and she has such pretty shades that I still haven't. There's too much to choose from, but this one, it is stunning. She does give some conversions here, but I don't really understand it. So yeah, go check out the site, because she has a Russian site, and she also has, I think her Etsy shop is for international, and her Russian site is also for international, but is in Russian. So you need to use Google Translate. Good luck with that. The next one, it is called the Falling Leaves palette from Emmy Cosmetics. It is available already. It's her fall palette. Let's see. There are some pretty shimmers in here. The mattes are not for me. First off, I think it lacks depth. But that is me personally. I would have loved to have a more orangey matte here. And a very deep dark brown or a black. To really, you know, be able to really create depth and smoke out the look. And to be quite honest with you, looking at the picture of the swatches here, if I look at time, the top two, so Time to Fall, Falling Leaves, and then the ones on the bottom called Athena and Bronze, I cannot read the lettering. Myth? I think it is. The tones are different, but I think that if you put them on your eye, they kind of blend into each other a lot, you know? So, yeah. Let me know down below what you think of this palette. If you have tried anything from Emmy Cosmetics. She is an indie brand from the US, I believe. But yeah, let me know down below what you think of it. Let's go to the next one, which I actually mentioned last week from Kaleidos Makeup. We had sneak peeks of their highlighters that they were coming out with. Here you see the picture, because they have launched. Yeah, they have launched. I think they retail for $14 each, yeah, or the bundle of 6 for $76. What do you think? I think they are pricier than I thought they would be. They look really, really pretty though, and the packaging looks cute as well. So, yeah, they look really pretty. I still really want to try their eyeshadow formula. And I will someday. But yeah, let me know what you think of these highlighters. I'm not really in a hurry to get any. Because for me personally, it is a little bit on the higher price point for highlighters. I'm not saying that they are not worth it. I'm just saying that, yeah, my wallet is a little bit small at the moment, you know? So yeah, I need to pick and choose my battles. And this unfortunately is not going to be one. But I do think they're really, really pretty though. Let me know if you have used them, what you think about them. Let's go to, Yeah, this real quick, which is kind of annoying, and I will tell you why in just a little. You see here a picture of the Oh Snap palette by Violet Voss. It is a limited edition gingerbread fun size mini eyeshadow palette. It's online at Sephora. It retails for $18, which I actually think is quite a good price. The trouble is though, the first time I saw the palette, I was like, eh. And then I saw the swatches and I was like, why do you do this to me? Because it is sucking me in. And you know why it is sucking me in? It is sucking me in because of the reds. I am a sucker for a good red shimmer. So there's that. Oh, this looks pretty. It's limited edition, so I'm not going to get it. But those reds, god damn it. They're sucking me in with the red shades. So I'm going to move on real quick. So yeah. Let's go to this, which is from Sample Beauty. Did I mention this already? I think I did, but I'm not sure that. This is the picture of their equalizer palette. I thought I knew what it retailed for as well. I have that here. It retails for £30. But what I actually find funny, I think that's actually a good idea. What they have done is they have kind of divided it up into different finishes. So you have one row is your mattes, one row is your shimmers, but they are corresponding names. So for the yellows, for instance, the top yellow, I think it's the matte, is called... Is it called rubber? Yeah, it's called rubber. And then the yellow shimmer is called duck. And that is how it... I think that's brilliant. I think that is so fun. So you can kind of put a queen duck on your eyes as well. If you would want a red crease and then a yellow shimmer. I think it's fun. I also think that spectrum in... how am I going to call this? You have that lighter green and then you have a darker green and there are enough shades in between that when you use them on your eye, you can see a difference. That is what I want to say. So yes, this is a bigger palette, but I actually quite like this one. I think this is a very pretty big palette and I would not hate to own this, to be quite honest with you. I think this is a very fun and good idea. Good for you, Sample Beauty. Yeah, I think a lot of people will really, really like this palette. What I really want to go quickly to is this one. Last week I mentioned that Tati is coming out with her own palette, but here you see the palette. And I have thoughts on it that are probably not going to be very... how am I going... I don't know. Let me just pull my thoughts. On the one hand, I think it is brilliant what she did. Because what did she do? The bottom row is a matte. Then the second row is, I don't know, a shimmer or something like that. Then you get a foilness and then you get something else. So she has the same color in four different finishes. Which I think is actually brilliant. However, the color story itself is kind of boring. For me, that is. There are two rows that I do really like. And that is the black row and the other row, which is called, it's the pinky row. So the first and the last row are the only two rows that I personally really like. If she would have put that in a palette, I would have been like, ooh, I want that. Yeah, it has launched already. It is $48. I wanted to show it because I know a lot of people are very, very interested in this palette. I also know that there are more people buying neutral palettes than colorful palettes, because basically a neutral for most people is something that they can wear every day. You know, not everyone is has the opportunity to wear this every day. Does that make any sense? So I'm not hating that. I think it is brilliant that she put the different finishes in. I know a lot of people are very excited about this. For me personally, as a color lover, it's boring as hell. However, I would love the first and the last row in a palette. I would have loved that. That is something that I could see myself picking up. I also said in my last video, last week, that Tati is not my kind of person. I think she's, I'm sorry to say, annoying. And one of you asked if I had a problem with saying that, and I actually do, because I don't want to hurt anyone's feelings. That is why I say she is not my kind of person. Because she's not. Maybe in real life she would be, but on camera, I don't like watching her. I'm sorry. Well, actually not, because I'm allowed to not like to watch her. I just don't watch her. I'm not going to go out and say underneath her videos that I don't like to watch her. I just don't watch her. That's the way it works, actually. But yeah, let me know down below what you think of this palette and if you are interested in it. I am interested to see how it performs, though. But yeah, let me know down below if you want to get it. This one I do want to mention as well, because this is just... I think it has released already. This is a collaboration between Mel Thompson and Christian Odette. It's her own lipstick line. Basically, it's two lipsticks and it is two lip liners. And the tin you see next to it was in the PR package. I think it's a candle, if I'm not mistaken. I watched her video on it. I've watched Mel for years. Not 10 years, but 2 or 3 years, ever since I really discovered YouTube, basically. I have been watching Mel, and this is really her. And I'm happy for her that she got this opportunity, you know. I think it is fantastic. And I think she put also, I do have to say that, she put a lot of thought into this collection. You may see here a nude lipstick and an orange lipstick, but... go watch the video. I will link it down in my description box. Go watch her video. And there you will see how much thought she put into these four products. I would love to try them out. However, they are too expensive for me. Because I think, if I am not mistaken, that this retails for $78. And that is too expensive for me. If I'm wrong, the price will be in the screen. It's just too expensive for me. So yeah, congratulations, Mel, on your line. And I hope that much, much more will follow. I would love to own it, but I cannot afford it. So there's that. Let me know what you think down below. I think I want to mention two things. So here you have from... Bys Cosmetics. How am I going to pronounce that? BYS Cosmetics. It's an Australian brand. That is the reason I wanted to mention this. It's their Malibu collection. How cute is this? We are going into fall and winter, but I know Australia and, well, basically the other half of the world is going into a spring and summer, and this is perfect for that time of year, you know? This is... oh, it's giving me summer vibes. I really, really like this. And that is the reason that I want to mention it. BYS. I don't know if they ship internationally. I have no freaking idea. I don't really know what this stuff retails for either. Maybe I have it here. Yeah, so here I have prices. The Malibu Eyeshadow Tin 16. Every price that I'm going to mention is in Australian dollars. So I only have to say it once. So Australian dollars, remember that. $16.95 is the eyeshadow palette. The Malibu On The Go palette is $11.95. Blush and Bronze Malibu $7.95. Highlighter Santa Monica $7.95. Malibu Waterproof Mascara Blackest Black for $7.95. Makeup Brushes in Keepsake Tin Malibu for $16.95. Then the Malibu Brush and Sponge 6-Piece Kit for $22.95. This is so cute, guys. I love this. I love this a lot. So if you live there or you can get your hands on it, go. Because this looks so fun. And if you have, let me know how it is down below. I would really like that eyeshadow palette. If I'm being honest, it looks so cute. Yeah. Okay. Let's see. Because I think I have one more thing. What's this? The trouble is, I want to mention so many new things. But I think that it is going to be a very, very, very long video. So let's just quickly go to this from Root Cosmetics. Because they have... they are called City of Flashing Lights Micro Liner. They are eyeliners or eyeliner pencils in neon-y colors. And they retail for $5.50. If you have tried them, let me know how they are. I can get Root Cosmetics here without any problems, actually. If I see these, maybe I will try one. You never know. I'm still looking for a good yellow eyeliner. So yeah, there's that. They are very, very pretty nonetheless. Let me know down below. I already said that. If you have tried them. Let's go quickly to... I have... two things left. So let's start with this one then. Last week I mentioned Huda's eyelash glue. And one of you said... she also came out with an eyeshadow palette. I missed it, guys. So let's talk about it now. So here you see a picture of her eyeshadow palette. I thought I had swatches somewhere too. I just don't remember where. Oh, here I think. The palette retails for... oh, wow. Really? Wow. The palette retails for $67. So keep that in mind. And it is called Mercury Retrograde. It's here. Well, it's here, yeah. So you have mattes, creamy metallics, you have a glitter, why? And a sheer multi-reflective shadows. It's online already. It does look really, really pretty, guys. That teal and then that... it's sucking me in. But for $67, I can easily skip. It does look really pretty though. It looks, I'm not going to lie, it looks really pretty. It looks luxurious. The colors look really, really pretty. I do have to say that that bluey, what is it, light teal color that she put in there really jumps out at me. So I like that arm better than the other arm, swatching wise. But yeah, she looks really, really pretty. She's expensive, but she looks really, really pretty nonetheless. I have one thing left and then it's done. This is a reveal of the first XO Beauty Shop eyeshadow palette, because this is Shan XO's brand. It's called Heaps of Sweets. That's the palette name. And it will launch on the 1st of November at 12 p.m. NZT. Via xobeautyshop.com. Is she based in New Zealand then? That could very well be. That she's based in New Zealand. I actually don't know. It looks really pretty though. It looks really cute. It's not really revolutionary. I don't follow Shan XO, to be quite honest with you. I have heard mention that it is really her. I don't know, because I don't follow her, but I do really like the color story. I think the color story is fun and cute, and I really, really like it. I don't know what it retails for. Can I find out? Christchurch, is that New Zealand? I think it is. So, yeah. Yeah, New Zealand, it said so. Really, wow, what the fuck? Oh man. So yeah, it looks really, really pretty, guys. I'm sorry, I cannot find what it retails for. She's, as I said, based in New Zealand. But yeah, that's the last thing, finally, that I have for this week's new makeup releases. And I thought, you know what? I don't have a lot this week. I was so, so wrong. Because it was a lot again. And it is probably going to be a lot because of the holidays. And... you know, new brand starting and stuff that I find, stuff that you guys show me. So, yeah. Let me know down below what you thought of all the finds that I had this week. And I think that was it. Yeah, I think that was it. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. It will help me tremendously. It will let YouTube know that you like me and my content. And that it needs to spread me over more people... that sounded really not good. So let me just close off the video before I do... I don't know what I'm going to say next. So yeah, guys. Thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day. A fabulous evening. And I will see you soon in my next one. Next one. I need to stop. Bye, guys. It's so windy outside. I hope my falsies stay on today. Maybe I should have tried Huda's new... glue.